There's a reason why Kerala is a place of choice when it comes to Ayurveda. Ayurvedic food, massages and lots of greenery, trees provide fresh air and oxygen to the body, which is essential for relaxation, rejuvenation and healing the body. Hi everyone and welcome to Sugar Spice Nice. My name is Shweta and in this video I'm sharing my Kerala Ayurveda experience with you. I picked this experience as my last stop in Kerala. So I checked into a place called Somatheeram, an Ayurvedic resort and hospital in Chowara, which is very close to Kovalam, and requested them to allow me a two-night stay to experience this bliss. So this is my room here at Somatheeram. It is like a cute little cottage, and the first thing that catches your eye when you enter the room is this bed, which is so beautifully covered with this jali or net to protect from mosquitoes and stuff, which are quite common in a super green area. The room does have that really nice cozy vibe. The lighting is pretty dim, and actually outside right now it's raining, so it's kind of looking really dull, and it's the perfect room to get really good sleep. I found the bathroom really clean, like it is spick and span. They have their own Somatheeram branded products. Somatheeram is filled with trees, plants, herbs and even some freshly grown vegetables. Oh, these are different varieties of brinjals growing right here. These are chilies. Not just the greens, you can also witness the beautiful water from here. That is the beach there, and a part of the beach belongs to the property itself. So it's like a private beach experience. Food is a very important part of Ayurveda, and with the right food, you can heal your body and also prevent diseases. So let me take you through a typical Ayurveda food experience here at Somatheeram. Come on. This is the restaurant, and dining here is not just a healthy but a very visually appealing experience. Welcome to an Ayurvedic breakfast. So there's raw ginger water, and you can see the prakriti is mentioned, the kind of composition it is good for. So if you're treating a vata imbalance, then this is the water. Then this is jeera water for a kapha imbalance. Then there are fresh juices, and this section I like to call the raw goodness section. So most of the stuff here is raw, salads, fruits, all of that. This is looking so wholesome. It's fruit, grated coconut, sprouts. One of the best breakfasts that you can have. This rice soup, oats porridge, steamed banana, sauteed vegetables. And there is upma, which I'm pretty certain I'm going to be having. Potato curry, carrot idli, wow. Porridge, there are appams. And along with appam, there's a banana stew. Then this section here is vegetable juices. So stuff that you can have empty stomach. So this is my breakfast, and I got myself some carrot idlis, upma, sambar and chutney. And this is the herbal water which they serve you at all times to promote digestion, to promote well-being. I'm starting with the upma. It is a little bit dry, but I'm loving the veggies it has. Carrots, French beans. Next, I'm trying the carrot idlis. Amazing. The idlis are so soft. This is probably one of the most delicious sambar I've had. Firstly, just look at the number of veggies in it. The flavor is absolutely on point. For my next round, I actually got some fresh fruits. So there's chopped pineapple, watermelon and a banana. And enjoying this with the gorgeous view, sounds of the waves is just beautiful. finally for some tea. I've been loving their tea. This is special masala tea and it is the strongest tea that I've had all throughout my Kerala trip. So I got some sweet corn soup from their soup section, and this is what sweet corn soup looks like with absolutely no corn flour. And then there is this red gram chaat. So basically red gram, some chopped onion, I think a little bit of tomato and coriander. For lunch today, I've picked out a lot of veggies. So this is some bhindi, ladyfinger vegetables tossed with methi. This is carrot and beans. And this is some potato. And there is some dal rice. So this rice is actually sesame rice. I've never really had sesame rice and it's got a good flavor, along with papad, pickle and some lime. It's tasting very, very good. Trying out the bhindi masala next. You can almost feel the crunch of the bhindi. It's not completely soft and mushy. It's got a very good flavor from all the onion and tomato. I'm going to be trying some aloo, classic jeera aloo. I'm quite surprised there's no curry leaves in this, because I've seen curry leaves in just about anything. Next, I'm trying the methi and the vegetables. Let's try some of those carrots and beans. I think they've been sprinkled with a little bit of coconut. So this is my plate of dessert. I saw cut peru guava, so I got some of that. I saw this thing called pineapple kesari. It looks like a barfi, but it's really, really soft. So I'm looking forward to trying this. And of course, my staple, sesame til laddu. So no matter how many days I spent in Kerala, I've still been calling it tilgur every single time. You can take me out of Mumbai, but you can't take the Mumbaikar out of me. The pineapple kesari is excellent. It is soft, melt in your mouth, and mostly sweet with a hint of, you know, pineapple sourness. But I will still stick to my first love, which is this. The way they make it is absolutely perfect. So I'm having some spinach soup. This thing is the real stuff. You can actually feel that bitterness of the spinach. So this is my dinner plate. I got some pasta. This is pasta and spinach sauce. This is green gram and spinach thoran. This is like a vegetable tikki. And this is some paratha. I've actually been having rice every single night, so I just decided to go with paratha today. Starting with the pasta first. Flavor that you get is that of spinach quite a bit. I'm gonna be trying the tikki now. It's got a lot of ginger, which is feeling exceptional. Now my staple dessert here has been these sesame balls. I've just enjoyed them thoroughly every single day. And of course bananas, but today I'm also trying some lemon souffle, and this seems like some kind of a halwa. Ayurveda is also about detoxifying and healing the body through massage. I tried a 60-minute body massage experience here. A typical Kerala Ayurveda massage is hardcore. It's more invigorating than relaxing, in my opinion. It's almost like malish, but it's something that one must experience. And after the massage, of course, I sipped on some coconut water, which is available in plenty all throughout the resort. Ayurveda, when combined with some physical exercise, works wonders for the body. So they have a pool here. It almost looks like an infinity pool of sorts going into the ocean. How gorgeous is it? They also have a yoga class, which I think I'm going to go and experience. So they have different types of yoga classes, a more advanced one, beginner, intermediary, and you basically take that depending on your personal level of practice. Somatheeram is one of the first Ayurvedic resort in the world. They started in the year 1985 from this very place, and today they have multiple properties. Now let me tell you this, the stay here is something you do for your health. So you could want to experience more relaxing treatments, anti-aging treatments, slimming treatments, or treating certain serious conditions. But everything begins with a doctor's questionnaire, and a consultation happens after that, after which they determine your doshas and the imbalance. That is what Ayurveda is all about. And all of the food, all of your therapies are decided thereafter. Normally they recommend staying for about 7 to 14 nights depending on the kind of treatments you want to go for. But for the purpose of this video, they were happy to host me for 2 nights so that I could get a glimpse of the experience and share it with you guys. So if you're curious to know more about this place, I'm going to leave all of their details on the screen and in the description bar below. You can check out their packages, you can check out their various locations and decide if this is something that you would like to go in for. And that is really it from me in this video. I hope you guys enjoyed my Kerala Ayurveda experience. I absolutely did. In fact, it was just for 2 days, but I am thinking, when am I going to get to experience this at least for 7 days? So I hope I get to come back soon. Do hit that thumbs up, share this video with all of your friends and family who are curious to know about Ayurveda, who want to get that Ayurveda wellness experience. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I hope you guys have been enjoying my Kerala videos so far. If you've missed any of the previous ones, I'm going to link all of them in the description bar below. So make sure you check those. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.